Thank you. thank you very much. I am very much honored to be present here as a resource person. Let's come into our the topic of today. Okay. Intellectual property rights. I think that the slide is visible, and I will be going through the slides rather than making it in presentation mode. I will be going through the slides. Okay. Hope my screen is visible so that I can continue. May I? Thank you. Thank you very much. So here are the points that we are going to discuss in this webinar. Introduction, branches of IPR, the overview of laws, sections and penalties, PhD thesis in related to IPR, and what can a cyber victim do. And last we have the question answer session. Question answer session, you can ask anything that is that is related to our topic or your doubts regarding the presentation, etc., or any other doubts. Slide is not visible. Okay. Thank you for making me aware of it. I was just thinking that my slide is visible. Is it visible now? Visible. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I am wishing to maximize. I will maximize whether, if I am going to maximize, will it go? That's what I was doing. What was thinking? If it went off, if the slide went off, please inform me. Okay, so that I will make alternate arrangements. Okay. Thank you very much. From the current slide, is it visible now? Thank you very much. Okay. It's full screen now. Thank you. So this is what we are going to say about in this presentation. Introduction, branches of IPR, overview of the laws and sections and penalties, PhD thesis in related to IPR, what can a cyber victim do? IPR are the legally recognized exclusive rights to the creation of the mind. Intellectual property refers to the creations of the mind, such as inventions, literary and artistic works, designs and symbols, names and images used in commerce, etc. IPR is an intangible asset. It's a reasonable monopolistic right for person's labor. That's in simple sentence. In simple sentence, intellectual property is a reasonable monopolistic right for a person's labor. That means if you copyright, if you apply for copyrighting a work, you can get the benefit out of it. Unless you copyright the work, you cannot take the benefit or you cannot claim the benefit. Same is the kind with patent also. If you patent a work, then you can get reward out of it. Unless you patent it, you cannot take the reward out of it. I think that it's clear, almost clear out of, because I have just now mentioned about the various aspects of IPR. Now I am saying in a nutshell what IPR mean in a nutshell. That was what I was saying. So TRIPS is an agreement on trade and related aspects of intellectual property rights. TRIPS is an international agreement administered by World Trade Organization. It established the minimum standards for regulation of intellectual property among World Trade member nations. It has 158 country members. It's just we can go into the branches of IPR. There are various branches of IPR: patent, copyright, trademark, design, geographical indication, trade secret, and plant varieties, and etc. Are the branches of intellectual property. Slide is not moving. Are you seeing the branches of IPR now? Oh, second slide. Only second. Okay. Now you are visible. Now second slide. Third slide visible. So, okay. What we are saying was about the legally recognized rights. What is meant by intellectual property rights? We are saying about what is meant by intellectual property rights. Intellectual property rights is the legally recognized exclusive rights to the creation of mind. Intellectual property refers to the creations of a mind, such as inventions, literary and artistic works, designs, symbols, names and images used in commerce, etc. The intellectual property is an intangible asset. What is meant by intellectual property in simple terms? In common layman's terms, what is meant by intellectual property? Intellectual property is a reasonable monopolistic right for a person's labor. That's in layman's term, intellectual property means. Intellectual property means a reasonable monopolistic right for a person's labor. It will get exhaust within, only for a specific period of time, not more. Okay, not more than a specific period of time, intellectual property rights could be claimed. What is agreement on trade related aspects of intellectual property rights? TRIPS is an international agreement administered by World Trade Organization. It established the minimal standards for regulation of intellectual property among WTO member nations. It has a total strength of 158 country members. That was regarding the history of intellectual property rights. Okay, nothing more about it. I am just mentioning about the branches of intellectual property. There are so many branches of intellectual property right, like patent, copyright, trademarks, designs, geographical indications, trade secret, plant varieties. So this is how the intellectual property rights is managed in India. We have a patent office, we have a trademark registry, a geographical indication registry, and patent information system. The copyright is governed by the Ministry of Human Resources, HRD Ministry. The Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers' Rights Authority works under the Ministry of Agriculture. Now we can go into the overview of penalties and offences as per Indian laws. The breaking of a patent or breaking of an intellectual property right will definitely amounts to will definitely be counted as an offence, and it will be penalized. Which are all the penalties, and what are we going to say? Cyber stalking is strictly following the tracking chats. It could be penalized in IT Act section 66-67 and section 354D, 499, 503, 507, 509 IPC. So that's how cyber stalking. When we say about cyber stalking, we will say that it's the tracking of chats. Tracking, because these things are happening nowadays. So I thought that it will be better to say about that also, cybercrime also. What is meant by cyber pornography? Cyber pornography is the publishing of obscene material in electronic format, including child pornography. Child pornography is also punishable. Pornography is also punishable. It will be regulated in intellectual property regulated under IT Act 2000 and its amendments, intellectual indecent representation of women's act, POSCO Act, and Indian Penal Code. Section 67 IT Act, Section 67A, 67B, IT Act 2008, Section 292, 293 IPC, Section 13, Section 14, Section 15 POSCO, Section 6, Section 7 of Indecent Representation of Human Rights, Women's Indecent Representation of Women's Act. These are all the sections that is related with cyber pornography. Let's move on to IP crimes. Intellectual property crimes include source code tampering, piracy, copyright infringement, etc. It will be dealt with dealt with in the following laws by enacting the following laws: Information Technology Act 2000, Copyright Amendment Act 2012. The specific sections are Section 65 IT Act, Section 65B Copyright Amendment Act. There are so many other sections also. Just I was mentioning about the mentioning briefly about what are all the immediately related sections. Other sections are also there. Cyber crime is a theft of immovable, can be said as a theft of immovable property. Cyber crime means that crimes done in cyber world. It could be registered under section 378 IPC. Promoting enmity among different religious groups could be penalized in section 153A and 295A IPC. Section 121 IPC deals with waging or attempting to wage war against government. These things must be in one's mind while publishing. That's why I was mentioning about this in the IPR in a session in IPR, because IPR laws are primarily meant for those who publish and those who are productive, those who share information relating to publishing, poetry, drama, etc. Because while publishing, we must consider all these things in our mind. Whether it will lead to cyber crime, whether it will be waging a war against government, whether it will be a cyber, whether the material contains cyber pornographic material, etc. These things must be kept in our mind. That's why I took my time to speak about it during our session. Let's move on to our business. We are going to patents. Patents Act 1970 says that a patent is a right or a limited monopoly that is given to an invention or a process for making and using and selling an invention. The patent could be of two types: one, product patent, and two, process patent. Product patent is a patent given to a product, and process patent is a patent given to a process. Product patent will be covering the product patent means one product will be patented and nobody else could create that product. A process patent means a process which is patented could not be used by any others except for the patentee or the licensee. The essential conditions for granting patent are novelty, inventiveness, usefulness, etc. this is the process. Patent will be granted after complying all the requirements that is given in Patent Act. The term of a patent is 20 years from the filing of a patent application. Addition can be done in existing patent. Section 84 Patents Act says of compulsory licenses after 3 years of granting patent. Government has the power to use innovation for the purpose of government. It is said in section 100, because it's only the public that is restricted from using patent. Government can use the patent for its purposes that is meant for governmental use or for the benefit of the public. For an incremental change, patent cannot be given. That decision was taken by in the case Novartis AG versus Union of India and others. It was decided in 2013 Supreme Court verdicts. For incremental changes, patent cannot be given. Because patent is given only to its invention that is very innovative in nature and not for a substantial improvement. Because novelty is the principle in which patent could be awarded. Section 3 of Patents Act mentions of the exclusions. A set of exclusions are there from those regarding those inventions which cannot be patented. I don't want to detail about it, because detailing about it will take a few more time, because things that is not relevant, that is against the nature, principles of nature, are not given patents. Not those inventions which is against the inventions, against the principles of nature, are not given patent, which is related to national security, etc., are not given patent, which will be a threat to the government, threat to the government or to the neighbors. If we make an invention to create a bomb, that will not be given. That will not be patented. A medicine to kill all the people, that will not also be given patent. Let's move on to Copyright Act. Copyright Act 1957 is meant for protecting literary and artistic work primarily, but it also through amendments, it also gives protection to computer works, computer programs also. The Act covers databases, and the creator of the work is accorded with lifetime copyright, which will continue to be valid a little more after his death, that is until 60 years after his or her death. Till 60 years of his of the death of the validity of the of the copyright will be 60 years plus the death of the author. That's how we can get the works of Shakespeare, Milton, etc., without patent. The creator is not only vested with the rights of authorship, but also the rights of protecting his or her works against amendments. The Copyright Act is protects the work from amendments also. The year 1984 witnessed the inclusion of computer programming. The inclusion of computer programming into the Act. Computer programming was not there in Copyright Act 1957. It was introduced introduced by amendment. Foreign broadcasting, the protection is for 25 years. 25 years is the protection given for a broadcasting. Let's move on to the civil remedies in Copyright Act. Civil remedies. Civil remedies include permanent injunction, damages or cost of profits, delivery of infringing property for destruction, provision of the cost of legal proceedings to a defender, imprisonment for a period ranging from 6 months to 2 years, fine ranging from 50,000 to 2 lakh rupees. The following are the rights of an owner. An owner of a copyright can transfer the copyright as a whole or as parts. He has the right to sell in a particular country and could be assigned to a person to be sold to a person while retaining other rights. It can be transferred to a person or a group of persons. Fair use. Fair use is a term that all must be knowing about, because even though the copyright has many restrictions in using a particular work, fair use provision gives the provision for using a work for the following purposes: private use, criticism, use of a program for the purpose it was supplied, for making backup copies as a temporary protection. Because these things are made, fair use has been a part of Copyright Act, because in order to make an improvement to a substantial, in order to make an improvement to a work, fair use is essential, because only through research we can improve a product. Criticism will be based on a particular aspect of a product which is not up to the mark, so that the owners can identify what are the problems and rectify according to it. Reproduction of a work for judicial reporting. For judicial reporting means if a judicial officer says that this particular work is required for a judicial proceeding, then he must be given that work. That is said in the Copyright Act. Reproduction of works for the use of members of legislature. It is also mentioned in fair use provision. The use of material for abiding with the laws in force, because for example, if we want to prevent a landslide and we say that this particular thing is copyrighted and we cannot use that technology, that is not that is against ethics. That's why this provision has been made. Reading an extract in public audience. An extract from public audience. Reading an extract in public audience means if we have a set of poetry and that book is copyrighted, and we say that one poetry cannot be read in audience, that is not permissible. We cannot say like that, because an extract from a book will not account to the totalness of the book. So reading an extract will not be hampering the rights of the author, because all the author is interested in getting money, and if the book is good, he will definitely get the money. And because substantial part of the book is not given to the public free of cost, he will definitely get the cost that he has spent for creating the work. So reading an extract in public also comes under fair use. Next we will move on to IT Act 2000. IT Act 2000 has 13 chapters and 90 sections. The offences as per IT Act 2000 comes under in the following sections. Section 43 deals with damaging computer system, downloading without permission, etc. Section 65 says that tampering with source code documents will land up to imprisonment up to 3 years and fine up to 2 lakhs. Section 66 hacking will result in imprisonment up to 3 years and fine up to 5 lakh. Section 66A is repealed for publishing offensive or false or threatening information. Section 66A IT Act is repealed, and we can say that Section 66B is punishment for dishonestly receiving stolen computer source or communication device. It will be punished with imprisonment for 3 years with fine, which may extend to rupees 1 lakh or both. Section 66C, using password of another another person. If you take the password and say that it's and take all the information that he has stored, that will be that will lead to imprisonment up to 3 years and with fine up to 1 lakh. It will also be booked under different other sections also regarding privacy. Section 66D says that if a person cheats somebody using a computer, he will be imprisoned up to 3 years and he will be fined 1 lakh rupees. Section 66E, publishing private images of others. It will lead to imprisonment of 3 years and with fine up to 2 lakh. Section 66F, acts of cyber terrorism will lead to imprisonment up to life. Section 67, publishing information which is obscene in electronic format. It will lead to imprisonment up to of 3 years and fine up to 1 lakh. 10 lakh. Section 67A, publishing images containing sexual acts. It could lead to imprisonment up to 7 years and fine up to 10 lakh. Section 67B, publishing child porn or predating child online. Imprisonment up to 5 years and fine up to 10 lakh on first conviction, and on second conviction, imprisonment up to 7 years and it fine up to 10 lakh on second conviction. Section 67C, failure to maintain records. A person deemed to be intermediary must be maintaining required records for stipulated time. Failure will lead to an absence. We have now seen acts related to intermediaries in the newspaper right newspapers now. Let's move on. Section 68, failure or refusal to comply with the orders. Failure or refusal to comply with the orders of government will result in imprisonment up to 3 years and fine up to 2 lakh. Section 70, securing access or attempting to secure access to a protected system. It will lead to imprisonment up to 10 years and with fine. Section 71, misrepresentation. Imprisonment up to 3 years and with fine up to 10 lakh. Section 72, privacy. Imprisonment up to 2 years and with fine up to 10 lakh. Section 72A, disclosure of information in breach of lawful contract. Imprisonment up to 3 years and fine up to 5 lakh. This is a comparison between this between IT Act 2000 and 2008. We move on to IT Act 2008, Section 66A. 66A prohibits the sending of offensive messages to a communication device. According to Section 69A, the central government has the power to block content where it believes that the content threatens the security of the state. Section 79 of IT Act 2008 regulates the liability of a wide range of intermediaries in India. In the coming slide, I am trying to prove that all committing cybercrime an individual is not only booked under cyber laws but also under other laws in India as well. This will result in the increased punishment for a supposedly petty cybercrime. This was included so that the students may deter from doing cybercrimes. Okay. According to IPC section 354(d)(1)(2), any man who monitors the use of a woman of the internet, email or any other form of electronic communication commits the offence of stalking. According to section 354(d)(2), whoever commits the offence of stalking shall be punished on first conviction with the imprisonment of either description for a term, which may extend to 3 years, and also be liable for fine, and be punished. And if he is punished for the second or subsequent conviction, he will be punished for imprisonment to 5 years, and also be liable for fine. According to section 425 of IPC, whoever with the intent to cause or knowing that he is likely to cause wrongful loss or damage to the public or any other person, causing the destruction of any property or any such change in the property or in the situation thereof, as destroys or diminishes its value or utility, or affects it injuriously, commits mischief. Damaging computer systems and denying access to computer system will fall within section 425. Section 425 mischief will also be charged against you if you damage computer. The maximum punishment for mischief as per section 426 is imprisonment up to three months or with fine or both. Following are some of the other sections related with cybercrime and IPC. If you do webjacking is punishable under section 383. Making bogus websites or cyber frauds is punishable under section 420. Section 420 says of cheating. Forgery of electronic documents and email spoofing will come under section 463 IPC. Sending defamatory messages is punishable under section 499 IPC. Email abuse is punishable under 500 IPC, and sending threatening messages by email is punishable under 503 IPC. Dishonestly receiving stolen property is punishable under section 411 IPC, and punishment for cheating is mentioned in section 419 IPC. Forgery for the aim of cheating is punishable under section 468 IPC, and forgery for the aim of harming reputation is punishable under section 469 IPC. Criminal intimidation by an anonymous communication is punishable under section 507 IPC, and sexual harassment by electronic method is punishable under section 509B IPC. Other laws related to protection of intellectual property are Customs Act, Companies Act, Micro, Small, Medium Enterprises Development Act, Code of Criminal Procedure, Competition Act, Biological Diversity Act, Cable Television Networks Regulation Act, Prasar Bharati, Broadcasting Corporation of India Act, Arbitration and Conciliation Act, Cinematograph Act 1952, Code of Civil Procedure, the Antiques and Art Treasuries Act, the Sea Customs Act, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, is said as UAPA, the Seeds Act 1966, the Indian Wireless Telegraph Act 1933, Indian Telegraph Act 1885, Publication in Oriental Language Act, Dramatic Performances Act 1876, etc. How to curb the use of dangerous documents? Those documents which comes under the purview of harmful publications as defined in Harmful Publications Act will be portraying commissions of an offense, acts of violence or cruelty, incidents of repulsive or horrible nature. Those publications which portrays the above things will be deemed as harmful publication. According to Section 3 of Harmful Publications Act, if a person sells, let to hire, distributes, publicly exhibits any harmful publication, he shall be punishable with imprisonment to 6 months with fine or with both. Those documents mentioned under Section 292 IPC, sale of obscene materials, will not be getting the protection under IP Act, and the documents are as follows: books, pamphlets, writing, drawing, painting, etc. tend to deprive and corrupt persons. Punishable under Section 292. According to Section 292E, this act will be punished with 2-year jail term in addition to 2000 rupees fine on first conviction and 5-year jail term in addition to 5000 rupees fine on second and subsequent conviction. In the succeeding slides, I have mentioned about 51 acts and sections in Indian laws which deals with cyber crime. Tampering with source code documents, Section 65 IT Act, Section 66 IT Act, hacking of computer systems, data alteration, sending offensive messages through communication device, Section 66A, dishonestly receiving stolen computer resource or communication device, Section 66B, identity theft, punishable under Section 66C, cheating by personation by using computer source documents, punishable under Section 66D, violation of privacy, Section 66E, Section 66F deals with cyber terrorism. Section 67 deals with publishing or transmitting obscene material in electronic form. Section 67A, publishing or transmitting material containing sexually explicit act. Section 67B, publishing or transmitting material depicting children in sexually explicit act. Preservation and retention of information by intermediaries. Section 67C, IT Act, powers to issue directions for interception or monitoring or deception of any information through any computer source. Section 69. Web jacking, Section 383 IPC, email abuse, Section 500. Online sale of documents under NDPS Act, punishment for theft under Section 379, theft of computer hardware, punishable under 378, obscene acts and songs, punishable under 294 IPC, sale of obscene objects to young persons, punishable under Section 293 IPC, obscenity, punishable under 292 IPC, punishment for criminal intimidation by an anonymous communication, punishable under Section 507 IPC, etc. are some of the major acts. Some of the Indian theses related to IPR, protection of intellectual property rights in India with steady reference to intellectual property in electronic form. Intellectual property rights of farmers in India, a legal study. Intellectual property rights, a case study with special reference to infringement of copyright in India. A critical study of the law relating to protection of intellectual property rights in cyberspace are some of the Indian PhD theses and IPR. Section 108(11A) of CRPC empowers the victim to call the magistrate of the locality and inform him or her about the person whom he believes could circulate any obscene material. Thank you. If there are any questions, you can ask. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it will be. Likes cannot be transformed into money, isn't it? That is the main problem. Likes cannot be transformed into money. That's why these sections are there. Because for creating an entertainment, lots of efforts are there by the part of the artists. Behind the screen, there are lot of efforts. So these people must get must earn their living handsomely. So for that they have made these much laws. So stealing will be actually considered as a sin not only by one person but an array of persons that is behind the screen. We all know only the producer or the director or the actor, but for a film there are some many other persons like lightman etc. who is always behind the curtain and he wants to get something, isn't it? That's why it's there. Yeah, it's stealing. It's booked under stealing also. The copyright, many of the, for example, the film called Mr. Perfect. Have you heard of it? Mr. Perfect. Allu Arjun film. Allu Arjun, I don't know, and Telugu film. Mr. Perfect. Have anyone heard? Mr. Perfect was, there is an issue with it. Issue with the Mr. Perfect because copyright infringement, a case of copyright infringement has been launched by the persons behind Mr. Perfect. They say that the story was taken from some other person and he have to be given the royalty. Allu Arjun was sued. Yeah, they will be punished, definitely.
You will be jailed.
No. No fine at all. You will be jailed actually. Okay. Thank you. Any other? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. വിജയ് പറയാണ്ട് പറയടാ. ഓക്കെ ഫൈൻ.